What if I told you with three simple changes, we can make the Digimon TCG a heck of a lot better? If that interests you, you're at the right video. What's up, Tamers? Yes, you heard me correctly. We got three things that are gonna make this game a heck of a lot better. Well, if you're new to the channel, my name's Ty. I love making Digimon content. And if that stuff interests you, think about hitting the subscribe button and definitely giving this video a like, because only way people are gonna see it is if you like and share it. So do both those things. Alright, without further ado, let's get into my three things. First thing I think that will change the Digimon TCG for the better is adding a mulligan system. If you don't know what a mulligan system is, pretty much the idea of it is at the beginning of the game, you look at your starting hand, say, I don't like this, and then you get a new hand. Every game has their own little twist to it, and the fact that this game doesn't have one, I find to be a bit of an issue. My buddy once said, mulligans only make games more skill-based. And there's a good reason for that. So it adds skill to the game because you look at your starting hand and go, this isn't what is going to get the job done. I need a new hand. And then that makes players have to think, oh, is this hand good? Can I make this hand work? Or is it time to replace it? You're not going to replace your hand every time, but it's nice to have the option. So I think it will add a lot of value. What type of mulligan system do I think will be beneficial for the game? That's something we're gonna have to test out. Just so you know, possible future video idea, so hit the subscribe button down below so you can get that as soon as it comes out. Yep, that makes sense. I understand why the game doesn't have a mulligan system, or why it was never incorporated right in the beginning of the game, but I feel it's something to where it's something considered to add, because I think it will only benefit the game overall. So on to the second thought or addition, I believe, that will make the Digimon TCG better. This is probably going to annoy a lot of Rookie Rush and Security Control players. But let me explain. Both use the idea of hoping that option cards are in security. So my idea is option cards that can only trigger off of security if you have that color on field. This isn't anything crazy. This is how option cards are played regularly if you play it from hand. I think this is going to make the game a little more fair in the sense of it adds more thought into the game and how you play. Let's take a hypothetical. You got three guys on board. You're going to swing with all three of them, but you have nothing in the raising area. And you know you need to keep at least one color out, one guy out for that color, so option cards trigger if your opponent attacks. So it adds more skill, like, okay, do I just swing and then hope there's nothing in my security? And, you know, it adds like a value of trying to figure out what's your next best move. This also plays into if you are you're playing against someone, they swing with other guys, they got nothing on board, nothing in the raising area, no tamers. You go, okay, I know no option cards are going to trigger, so I'm going to go crazy and swing. It adds more skill to it. It makes you have to think a little more about your decision making. Both Rookie Rush and Security Control really play off of security cards activating for free off of insecurity. That's kind of the fundamentals of the deck. Not as much a Rookie Rush, but definitely Security Control. So all this is going to do is just make the Security Control players go, okay, I got to get a red tamer out as soon as possible so my Gaia forces work. And then I got to get a black tamer out as soon as possible so my ultimate flares go off, you know. These are things to where it makes the game more fair in the sense of, you know, you're playing against Security Control, swing as soon as possible because you know they have to get tamers out or people or Digimon on board. It just makes, and it's not like a crazy change. All you have to do is say, hey, new rule book, new rules. Option cards can only activate, the effects of option cards can only activate in security if you have that color on board. Same as if you were playing it from hand. It's not a huge change. It's not going to make the game completely different. It's just going to make it kind of nerfs them a little bit, because the reason those decks top a lot of events is because they play into, you know, they play like, you know, the game was fundamentally meant for something else, but it also worked. They kind of take a loophole. That's it. They loophole the game, and this will eliminate that a little bit. It will just make it a little more fair for everyone. It only adds you have to think a little more when you play. I don't think it's that big of a change. So that's my thoughts on that. And if you agree or disagree with anything I'm saying, please comment down below. I want to hear your opinions. I love going back and forth with people, not in a negative way, you know, just for fun. This is what this game is. It's fun to me. So talking and communicating about it is honestly important. And the last thing I think they need to add into the game isn't really an addition into the game. It's actually adding a mobile version of the game. Yes, I know. They have the app. They have that mobile app where it teaches you how to play the game. And that's such a good idea. It's such a good idea because it makes it more accessible for new players. And card games, that's honestly a big focus. They want to get new players into the game. They also want to keep existing players happy. That is the whole idea of what you want to do. And this will add to that. Having a mobile version of the game only benefits new players because they have a free version way to try the game out, see if they like it. Also, if cards are hard to find, it's an easy way to play. Also, it really helps out existing players to be able to test out decks and see if things work. It makes it just easier. Pokemon does it, and it's such a good tool, especially when you're trying to build decks, because you can build them, and then what? You have to then get the cards to test them. Say, oh, I don't like this. Before you say anything, yes, I know. There is, like, Tabletop Simulator, Untappd. There's ways to play the game online, but it's not as accessible to the masses as a mobile. Like, you have an app, everyone's going to use it. And I think that is really important for card games, especially nowadays in today's time. Having a mobile version, a way to play the game for free and test out things and try the game, most importantly, be free with, like, options to buy things, but you know, you can play the game. You don't have to pay any money to play it. I think that adds a lot. It's just a way to really help out with the whole growing the community and having online versions, I think, is A1. So, yeah, getting a mobile version. And I know it's possible because they have that app. And I also, just so you guys know, I know there's a rumor that there's going to be an online version of the game coming out in the near future. Well, distant future, near future, at some point down the line, there's going to be an online version, an official online version. But having a mobile version, I think, is better. And they already have the app. They already have the cards. Yeah, it's the starter decks, but they have them there. They have the resources. All they have to do is add the rest and maybe adding the full game features. I don't think it will be that crazy, and I think it will only benefit the game for the future. Alright, so those are my three things I think that will make the game a hell of a lot better. Alright, Tamers, that's it. Those are the three things I think that are going to make the game a ton better. Please down below comment. I want to hear your input on it. If you agree with me or you disagree with me. If you're a security control player and you don't like what I said, guess what, buddy? I have an opinion. Nah, seriously. If you agree or disagree, please comment down below. Give this video a like because it helps out a lot. And share it, because the more people who see it, the more, if you think these ideas actually might help the game out, we got to get it in the right people's eyes. So, you know, pass it along and please discuss. I want to hear your comments. Also, if you made it this far, you're A1, and I will have a deal. If you made it this far into the video, I want to play a game with you. I want to play against you. I want to see what decks you're running. I want to so bad. So here's my Discord, add me, and then we'll discuss and we'll get something going and we can have quality game. Add me on Discord, we'll have a chat, we'll play some games. It's going to be fun. So, yeah. Well, I appreciate you guys. Please like, subscribe, do whatever. Do all that YouTube stuff. It means a lot. And, yeah, catch you guys all in the next one. Peace. Also, watch out for pebbles.